What's up, YouTube? This is 82-0. Welcome back. So when you think of the Chicago Bulls, everybody thinks of the 90s Chicago Bulls, Michael Jordan, Scottie Pippen. But how many times do we hear about the 70s Chicago Bulls, specifically 1971 to around 76? How good was this team? And they're one of the most forgotten teams in NBA history. And I just wanted to take a look at them. So, the Chicago Bulls started in the 66-67 season as an expansion team. Because although Chicago before had a basketball team, the Zephyrs, this was their permanent home in Chicago. So, initially, they weren't a very good team the first four seasons in the NBA. But by the 70-71 season, this would be their first 51-31 season. Their first 50-win season. And they were coached by Dick Motta. And what was different about this team is they started improving offensively. And they built a good young core. And much of those early 1970s expansion teams, I mean, the Chicago Bulls weren't alone. You had teams like the Milwaukee Bucks, Phoenix Suns. These were all teams that got good pretty fast. And the 70s are known as the decade of parity because there was eight different teams that won. So, who was on their roster? The 70s Bulls were led by their power forward, Bob Love, and he's one of the most forgotten all-stars in NBA history. He's a two-time All-NBA, three-time All-Star, and three-time All-Defense. And the thing about Bob Love is he could get you a 25 points per game season. For example, the 71 and 72 season, he averaged 25 points per game. He wasn't the best rebounder for his position. There were seasons where he'd average six rebounds. But I think a lot of the reason why was, although he was listed as a power forward, a lot of the time they'd move him over to small forward. And a lot of the team's rebounding was done by other guys like Clifford Ray. But he had a very great mid-range shot. And one of the things about him was he was very strong. When he drove to the basket, you know, he wouldn't force himself. He had a great post moves. And, you know, if he was on a better team, like, say, a team that won, like the Lakers in the 70s or the Celtics in the 70s, he'd be a lot more talked about. But unfortunately, the players who don't win are the ones that are forgotten. But no doubt one of the best power forwards of the early 70s. A great defender, a great, great mid-range shooter, great post moves, great footwork, Bob Love. And in my opinion, the second best player on those early 70s Bulls teams was Jerry Sloan. Rest in peace. And I think most people remember him as coach of the Utah Jazz in the late 90s. He was a brilliant, brilliant coach. He coached those Utah Jazz teams to perfection. I think he coached them from, I want to say, like, 93? 94, something like that, up until 2011. So he had a long tenure with the Jazz. But as a player, he's a two-time All-Star, a six-time All-Defense. And like I said, with Bob Love, this was a great defensive team with Sloan and Love. And one of the things about Sloan, despite only being 6'5", he was a great rebounder, especially for the shooting guard position. He got as high as 9.1 rebounds per game, and he consistently averaged around 7 to 8. He wasn't the best scorer on the team. I'm not saying he was a bad scorer. He's pretty efficient, but he was like a second or third option on offense at some points, you know? His career high in points per game was 18.3 in 70-71. And I think it's safe to assume he averaged more than two steals per game for most of his career, because they didn't keep track of steals until the 73-74 season. And at that point, he was 31 and he averaged 2.4 steals. So a 6'5" shooting guard that could rebound, guard, shoot. On top of that, he had a great basketball mind. Jerry Sloan. Another addition to their team was Chet Walker. And many people remember him for playing with the 76ers throughout most of the 60s. But the Sixers traded him to the Chicago Bulls for Jim Washington and Bob Kaufman in 1969. He won a championship with the 76ers in 1967, so he gave them championship experience. And, you know, he was never the number one option, obviously, on offense in Philadelphia. But by the time he came to Chicago, he was the second leading scorer behind Bob Love. For example, in the 70-71 season, he averaged 22 points per game. And in 72, he averaged 22 points per game. His average with Chicago for the six seasons he played there was 20 points per game. A very efficient scorer, okay? I'm talking 47-50% field goal shooting was his usual average for the season. A great free throw shooter, 85% in 71. He averaged 85% for his six seasons in Chicago and 48% field goal shooting. Great rebounder for his position. An underrated defender. He wasn't ever an all defensive selection, but he could play defense. And he was a very smart player. He knew how to get his shots off. And to give you an example of how good of a defender he was, so in the 1968 season, for example, he was 13th in defensive win shares. And his player efficiency rating hovered around 20 when he was playing on the Chicago Bulls. So he was a solid third to second star. Chet Walker. Now, the other star I consider on this team is Norm Van Leer. Although he wouldn't join the Chicago Bulls until the 72-73 season fully. He did join the team in 71-72. He was traded, but his first full season was 72-73. And he was actually traded for quite a few times in his career. He was, believe it or not, he was drafted by the Bulls in 69, but the Bulls traded him right away to the Cincinnati Royals, and the Royals would trade him back to the Bulls for Jim Fox and I think a draft pick. But anyways, he had a really great career with the Bulls. Okay, his averages for his seven seasons with the Bulls is 12.2 points per game and 6.9 assists, 1.9 steals. And he's considered one of the, I mean, obviously Oscar Robertson's considered the first, but he was one of the first triple-double machines. To give you an example, in 71, he averaged 16 points, 7 rebounds, 10 assists. He led the league in triple-doubles. And to continue to their tradition of those Bulls having good defenders, Norm Van Leer was an 8-time all-defensive selection. He was a 1974 All-NBA, 1971 assist champion, and a 3-time All-Star. Unfortunately, he passed away in 2009. But one of the most complete point guards, and in my opinion, to give a modern comparison, I mean, it's always hard to compare players from different eras, but who he reminds me of is like a Rajon Rondo. You know, a solid defender. He's not going to get you 20 points, but he'll get you 16. He'll get you the 10 assists. He's a good rebounder for his position. In my opinion, that's a good comparison. And rounding out the bench, They had guys like Clifford Ray, who was a solid rebounder for them, and he was actually the team's best rebounder. In his 3 seasons with Chicago, he averaged 11.2 rebounds per game. He would eventually, at the end of the 73-74 season, be traded to the Golden State Warriors for the legendary Nate Thurmond. And Nate Thurmond, although he was 33 years old in the 74-75 season, and this team only won 47 games, which I'll get into later about their records. He did play one game with them. So think about how good that defensive lineup was. I mean, you had Bob Love, all defense, Norm Van Leer, all defense, Jerry Sloan, all defense, Nate Thurmond, all defense. So these Bulls teams had suffocating defense, and some other role players they had, a solid shooting guard they had, and he actually won a championship with Philly in 67 himself, Bob Weiss. He was a point guard slash shooting guard for them, solid shooter, come off the bench, giving them 11 points per game. And, they had a Rick Adelman who would go on to be a legendary Hall of Fame coach. So that's their bench, not the most depth. I mean, they had some good shooters, good rebounders around these guys, but it was mostly a defensive-oriented team. So why couldn't this Bulls team get it done? Now, what you got to understand is back then the Chicago Bulls were in the Western Conference. They hadn't moved to the Eastern Conference yet. And unfortunately, the Milwaukee Bucks were in the Western Conference back then too. So they just peaked at the wrong time because 71, their first 50-win season, they lose to the Lakers in 7 games in the first round. 72, they lose to the Lakers in the first round. They just get swept. 73, they lose to Lakers again in 7 games. I mean, they pushed the Lakers to the breaking point twice. And the Lakers made the finals in 72 and 73. So had they beaten the Lakers, I definitely think they would have made the finals. 74. Now the Lakers are no longer contenders because Wilt's gone, but you still got the Bucks to worry about. The Bucks swept them in the Western Conference Finals. And in 75, I consider this to be like the end of their run. They lost to the Golden State Warriors in 7 games. And the Warriors, to be honest with you, in my eyes, that was an upset. That 7 game, the Warriors won 83 to 79, but the Bulls theoretically should have won it. I mean, they were dealing with some injuries that season, particularly with Bob Love, but they should have done it. But the next season, that's when the team imploded. They went 24 and 58, and that was really the end of their run. And, at the end of the 70s, they would still have Norm Van Leer, but their new superstar that they had was Artis Gilmore, who, he never played on those early Bulls teams, so I won't talk about him too much, but he was kind of what took over for the late 70s, the Hall of Fame center. But that's the 70s Bulls, and they theoretically could have won a championship had they, been healthy, I think, in that 75 series. But, you can't ever put an asterisk on injuries. Now, this team was actually, in my eyes, on pace to win a championship. You got to look in the perspective of being a fan in that era. You're seeing a lot of these expansion teams get good enough to win, like the Bucks, and you had teams that made the finals like the Suns, And they actually averaged in that five season stretch, they averaged 52 wins. But they didn't have a Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. They didn't have a Wilt Chamberlain. Yeah, they had a lot of good players, a lot of Hall of Famers, a lot of good defenders. But the difference between them and their opposition was the Lakers had Wilt. The Lakers had West. The Bucks had Kareem. The Warriors, at the end of this five-year run, they had Rick Barry. Who did the Bulls have? You know, Bob Love, who I told you is a great player. Norm Van Leer, who was a great player. But the thing is, great players don't equal legendary, all-time great players. And that was the difference maker. So, unfortunately, this team has been really forgotten, and they didn't have a lot of success up until, obviously, the Michael Jordan era. And after that, the Bulls didn't really have any success. I mean, Derrick Rose came in, but this team has yet to win a championship since the Jordan era. So, that's the 1970s Chicago Bulls. Let me know your thoughts down below. Thanks for watching.